Hello guys, today I'm going to show you guys how to use ProBuilder. If you don't know what ProBuilder is, it's simply a free tool that helps you a lot when you're making maps for your game. Let's get right into it. First, you open Unity Hub and create a new 3D project. Then you go to Window, Packet Manager, go to Unity Registry, and then search ProBuilder. And then you hit install. After installing the package, you need to go to Tool, ProBuilder, and ProBuilder Window. To make it easier, you need to right click on the scene tab and then click maximize, so you have a clearer view of your scene. Now I will introduce you the first tool, which is quickly use the icon mode. Now the first tool is the shape tool, and when you click this, you have a little window right here, and the first row is you need to select the type of shape you want. What type of shape do you want to create? So if I want a cube, I select it, and then I drag from one place to another. And then if you want to set the height of the cube, you can drag it up. And then you have a cube. You can also change to other type of mesh as well. For example, if you want to create a staircase, you can use the stair icon and then drag from one place to another, and then drag it up, and then you have a stair. You can also change the height of the mesh by use the face tool and then select the upper face, drag it down. So you have create a platform like this. A common thing you want to do is to create a house. So now we have a new tool which is called a loop cut. So to enable it, you need to go to the edge selection tool, click on an edge, and then you will see the edge loop tool. If you click on it, you will see there's a cut on our floor. So let's drag it on one side, and the length of this from this edge to another to this is the thickness of the wall, so I want it to be minimum as well. So then you can drag it up to create our walls, but first we want to create more loop cuts. So let's select the edge one more time, use the loop cut tool, and then you have another loop cut. Let's drag it to one side. Let's create two more loop cuts. Let's select this first. So edge loop tool, drag it, and then create the final. Wait, no. Okay, let's create the final edge loop. So now, after you have the edge loop, all you gotta do is select the walls. Remember to select the corner as well. And what you want to do is select shift and then move the arrow upwards, and you will have the walls. Now if you want to quickly create a roof, you select shift one more time after releasing it, and then you have a small cut over here. Select the face, shift. Now a house, obviously it needs a door, right? So what you want to do, you use the edge selection tool, and then all you gotta do is use the edge loop again and then move it towards the side. Let's create another edge loop and click on the edge loop tool, and then the length between this edge and this edge is the width of the door. So okay, I will just leave it like this. And to make our door, all you gotta do is select this face and then shift, move it to the other side until you see the cut right here, and then you stop. And finally, just gotta select this face, and then you hit delete. And there you have our door, which is perfect. That is it for this video, hope you guys enjoy, and in the next video, I'll show you guys how to create windows and apply materials to our building. And be sure to smash the subscribe button for more videos. Bye!